Parker here.
So we have a topic that we often get this question when we work with sellers. When should I move out of the house? Sometimes people are wondering, should I go ahead and move things right away? Should I wait until the last minute to move things out? And so we wanted to kind of go through that a little bit with you to give you that right timeline for moving out of your house when you're selling.
Yeah, so usually people fall in one or two camps. They either want to get started the second they have a contract on their house, or they put it off until the last minute. And really in between is a sweet spot. So you want to wait until after your inspection process before you really get into the heavy moving, because you would hate to have something come up in your home inspection or termite inspection, the deal falls through, and you've already gotten all your stuff out. So usually that's within the first week or two. And similarly, if there are financing contingencies, you want it to look pretty solid that the buyer's going to be able to get financing and things like that before you start renting a storage unit or doing something along those lines. However, on the other side of things, the property is supposed to be broom swept by the time of settlement. So therefore, you do not want to wait until the day of settlement and still be moving things out. So definitely give yourself at least a day or two before settlement to be completely out of the house and ready to go.
Yeah, and the buyers are going to want to do a final walkthrough prior to settlement to make sure that the house is in the condition that they were expecting it to be in. And so you want to make sure that house is clean for them and everything's moved out so that they can really do an effective job as they do that final walkthrough the day or so before settlement.
Right. You don't want to scare them the day of settlement or the day before thinking that you're not going to be able to get your stuff out.
Yeah.
There are also some things that we recommend that you collect for the buyers as you're moving out. This just makes it easier on them, and a lot of these are even going to be in the contract that you will provide if they exist. So first of all, obviously any keys that you have to the house, you want to collect those. Also, any remotes like to fireplaces or fans, if you have anything like that. And then definitely garage door openers as well. These are things that are good, especially the keys and the garage door openers, to bring to settlement with you. So you can hand those over to the buyer right at the settlement table. It's also just nice if you have any information on your appliances, any warranty information, if your HVAC unit is still under warranty or you have a warranty on your roof shingles. There are a lot of different systems that might have warranties. It's great to leave that for buyers, especially if it's something that the buyer will be able to take advantage of as well.
Yeah, but if we get to the point of settlement and you have not yet moved out, then that is a big problem. So let's make sure we don't get to that point, because all kinds of different issues come up when that happens. Try to be completely moved out at least a day prior to settlement, have the house clean, broom swept, so the buyers have the opportunity to do that walkthrough and everybody's happy at that settlement table, so we don't have any angry buyers or anxious sellers at the settlement table.
Yeah, and you can use your agent, whoever that is, as a resource. So real estate agents work with people that are moving all the time. They should be able to refer you to a good person to help you move if that's going to be overwhelming for you.
Yeah.
So just some things to think about if you're selling your house about timeline.
Yeah, let us know if you have any questions in the comments below. Have a great day. We look forward to talking with you.